The Sundown close-up. New Hampshire Congressman Frank Ginta agrees to pay back hundreds of thousands of dollars, admitting that he broke campaign finance laws back in 2010. So why did he repeatedly contend that he had done nothing wrong? And Republican Senator Kelly Ayotte joins us with reaction to that, along with more about a busy week in Washington and the happenings on the campaign trail. Good morning, everyone. Thanks for joining us. I'm Josh McKelvin. By a lot of accounts, this has been a difficult week for New Hampshire Congressman Frank Ginta. On Tuesday, we broke the news that he had entered into a deal with the Federal Elections Commission, which included basically a concession that he broke finance laws, and it also came with a promise to pay back $355,000 in campaign contributions, as well as a hefty fine. So after years of saying that that money was his all along and that he had done nothing wrong, a lot of people, understandably, are asking for an explanation. So joining me this morning via satellite in Washington, D.C., Congressman Frank Ginta, thank you very much for joining us. Good morning.
Josh, good morning. Thank you for allowing me to be here with you.
Of course. So let's get right to it. For years, since 2010, you have said that this money was yours all along. You had done nothing wrong. So the question is, why would you enter an agreement with the FEC admitting that rules were broken?
Well, Josh, this has been a deeply personal matter for me. As you know, a political complaint was filed against me, the campaign, 5 years ago, and I've been trying to resolve this particular issue for 5 years. And also for 5 years, I've maintained that I made a reporting error, that I made a mistake, and I continue to maintain that I made that mistake. Even when I was out of office, Josh, I was trying to resolve this issue because I always thought it was a political distraction for the state. After I won in November, the FEC approached me and asked me to settle, and I thought that it was the right thing to do to try to resolve this and put it behind me. So as a result of that, I agreed with the FEC that I had a reporting error, that I did make, in fact, that mistake. And as a result, I'm paying a fine and I'm returning the loan as I always and originally intended. I think it's the right thing to do, Josh. I think it's the right thing to close this matter finally, and it's the right thing so I can continue to do the best I can to represent the people of the 1st Congressional District.
Congressman, the error that you allude to is regarding financial disclosure forms. That was amended. I grant you that. The question for the last 5 years is where that money came from that you had to make that amendment about. So I'm going to just ask you point blank. Did you accept any money from your parents or anyone else in excess of the allowable limit?
No, I did not, Josh. As a matter of fact, over the last 40 years, I have generated money into a family account going back to the 1970s. And those resources have always been mine. We as a family kept it in a family account. Most families don't look at what the name of the on the top of the bank account is. Your family bond is much stronger than that. But I have documentation that shows with my actual name on different accounts going back to the 1970s, from a passbook account to other small bank accounts to some stock that I got from my grandfather when he passed away after he worked for the Singer Company, to some property that I had owned that over time accumulated to more than the money I borrowed and loaned my campaign back in 2010.
And Congressman, you're asking people to accept the idea that over the course of years, you deposited more than a third of $1 million of your own money into an account with which you had no authority to get that money back from. With all due respect, sir, who does that?
Well, that's not exactly accurate how you just described it. This was resources and money that I had generated that went into a family account going back to prior to my 18th birthday. And in one circumstance, we're talking about money that when I was 3 years old, that was in trust for me, held by my folks as the custodians of a minor. So when you start to look at all of those dollars that were generated by me and put into this family fund, a family account, excuse me, over the last 40 years, it generated between interest and growth more than the amount that I borrowed from the account. The reality is that this was my money, Josh, and I was able to access it whenever I wanted, but I didn't believe that it was reportable under the FEC guidance. And that's the particular issue, and that's why I've always claimed I made a mistake. I am thoroughly sorry for that mistake, but I made a mistake. And because the FEC has decided, that they inquired that they wanted to settle with me, I thought it was the best thing to do, Josh, to try to finally put this behind me. So as a result, I am paying that fine because of what we agreed to, that I had an error in how I reported this asset. I am willing to pay that fine. I'm repaying the loan, which I always intended, and I can finally close the book on this complaint and move forward with representing the people of the 1st Congressional District.
If this was your money in an interest-bearing account, did you pay taxes on that interest?
Yeah, the taxes were always paid on any interest.
By you? This was on your tax return as generated income.
The taxes were always paid. Again, we're talking about money that goes back to the 70s and 80s, but taxes were always paid.
All right. So you say you have documentation that proves that this is your money, and it brings back to the question: after 5 years of telling people that this was your money and you did nothing wrong, suddenly you do enter into this agreement. You say the FEC approached you hat in hand, saying, "Let's make a deal." It's a pretty heavy levy to just agree to pay back $355,000 as well as a fine, not to mention the political implications of this. And a lot of people here, Congressman, I'm not going to mince words here, don't believe you. The publisher of the state's largest newspaper in an op-ed today called you a liar.
Well, I respect Joe. I've talked to Joe about this, and I plan on speaking with the union leader again and showing them the documents that I'm referencing. I look forward, Josh, when I am back in New Hampshire, to show you those documents as well. But the reality is, this is money that I generated going back to over a 40-year period, but going back to the 70s. And it was in a family account. I accessed a portion of my funds for a loan to the 2010 campaign. The FEC agreement is that I made a mistake. I made an error. I readily admit that. And as a result, I'm paying the fine. And as I always intended to pay back this loan, I am paying back the loan.
You say you have documentation. Was this provided to the Federal Elections Commission?
Yeah, I've been trying to resolve this with the FEC for years, but the federal bureaucracy sometimes is very frustrating. To be honest, the FEC is like the IRS of political campaigns. I can't dictate when they decided to try to, work with me on this. There were periods of time, Josh, where they were dormant on this particular issue. And again, even when I was out of office, because I thought it was the right thing to do, I was trying to resolve it with them. And Josh, it wasn't until after the November election that I won, they contacted me and inquired about a settlement. And I thought, again, it was the right thing to do to finally put a political distraction and something that has been used against me for years behind me. So as a result, I am admitting, and I have admitted, that I did make that mistake, that reporting error. I shouldn't have done it. But as a result, I'm paying the fine, I'm paying back the loan as I always intended to do, I'm closing the books on this particular issue, and I'm going to be able to get back to fully representing the people of the 1st Congressional District.
But Congressman, if you have proof that this is your money, why did the FEC come to you with this agreement asking you, which you signed, saying that, yes, I broke the rules and I'm paying the price for it?
Sure. Well, we have always showed them these very same documents and others, and I can't speak for them and why they made the decision that they made. They have a different interpretation probably of the FEC guidance, but in terms of how to disclose this. But honestly, this was about how I didn't properly disclose money that was mine. I made a mistake, Josh, but the reality is this was my money going back to decades, going back to the 70s, and I have different documentation of different accounts, passbook accounts, different bank accounts. Again, stock from my grandfather that I inherited years and years and years ago when he passed away. Real property that I owned. All of those resources were always put into this family fund. I always knew that this was my money. My family always knew that this was my money. Did my mom cut me a check? Yes. But was it her money? No. This was my money.
All right, I'm just going to ask you now, what is your pathway forward, and do you feel at this point that you owe anybody an apology?
Well, look, I have always said, Josh, that that I made a mistake. I'm sorry for that mistake. I truly am. I wish I never made this mistake, because this has been a 5-year political distraction, and that's why I thought it was the right thing to do when the FEC approached me to finally settle. I want this behind me, I want it behind you, and I want it behind the people of the great state of New Hampshire. So I am doing that, and I am paying the fine that they're asking me to pay in the agreement. And I hope that closes the chapter on this particular issue, and I can move on and continue to do what I love, which is representing the people of our state.
All right, Congressman, thanks very much for your time this morning. Best of luck to you moving forward.
Sure. Thank you, Josh. I look forward to seeing you and showing you the documents as well.
Indeed. All right. We're going to be right back with reaction from Senator